Hi, welcome to Enchiridion. I am very excited to share with you these facts on Tupuxuara. Tupuxuara was a diurnal pterosaur that lived close to the sea and is considered to have hunted for fish and thus having a piscivorous diet. It was a large crested and toothless pterodactyloid pterosaur from the Albian stage of the Early Cretaceous period of what is now the Romualdo Formation of the Santana Group, Brazil, roughly 112 million years ago. Tupuxuara is closely related to Thalassodromeus, and both form a group that is called Thalassodromidae, if placed within the Neoazhdarchia, or Thalassodrominae, if placed within the family Tapejaridae. The genus was named and described by Alexander Kellner and Diógenes de Almeida Campos in 1998. The holotype MN6591V was discovered in the Early Cretaceous Albian Stage of what at the time was known as the Santana Formation, currently known as the Romualdo Formation of Brazil. It consists of a snout and some partial wing bones. Mature individuals of Tupuxuara longa cristatus had a backswept crest arising from the snout. Later, more fossil material was discovered, each unique and showing considerable variation in morphology. On the one hand, some researchers assumed there are different species present, while others explained this as intraspecific variability, the source being a difference in age or sex. In 1994, Kellner named a second species, Tupuxuara leonardi. The specific name honors Giuseppe Leonardi. The holotype is MN6592V, a fragmentary skull with a rounded crest. Other similar material has been referred to Tupuxuara leonardi. The largest skulls have a length of 4.3 feet or 130 centimeters, suggesting a wingspan of 18 feet or 5.5 meters. In 2009, a third species was named, this time by renowned paleontologist Mark Witten, Tupuxuara deliridamus. The holotype is SMNKPAL6410, a skull. Another skull is the paratype, KPMNHDL84. The specific name is derived from Latin deliris, meaning crazy or insane, and adamus, meaning invincible, but also the word from which diamond is derived. The species has low eye sockets and a distinctive diamond-shaped skull opening. The name is a tribute to the song Shine On You Crazy Diamond by Pink Floyd, one of Witten's favorite bands. The elaborate crest indicates the presence of an extensive network of blood vessels. Despite possibly being used for thermoregulation, it is more probable that Tupuxuara flushed blood into the crest to produce a striking and vivid color display. Like other crested pterosaurs, study of diverse specimens suggests that the crest got larger as the individual grew, as a sign of reproductive maturity. Tupuxuara means familiar spirit. The generic name Tupuxuara refers to a familiar spirit from the mythology of the Tupi, a group indigenous to Brazil. It was named by Kellner and Campos in 1998. It belongs to the kingdom Animalia, the phylum Chordata, the order Pterosauria, the suborder Pterodactyloidea, the clade Asdarchoidea, the genus Tupuxuara, and the type species Tupuxuara longa cristatus. Tupuxuara is a member of the group Asdarchoidea. Kellner assigned it to the Tapejaridae within Asdarchoidea. According to some analysis, however, Tupuxuara is closer to the Asdarchidae than the Tapejara and its relatives. Asdarchidae is a group that includes the giant taxon form Quetzalcoatlus. The cladogram below follows the 2011 analysis of Felipe Pinheiro and colleagues. Below is a cladogram showing the phylogenetic placement of Tupuxuara within Neoazhdarchia from Madras and Myers of 2013. While it was once suggested that Tupuxuara was a piscivorous or fish eater at the coast of South America, other hypotheses include the possibility that it was a frugivore, or fruit eater. Nonetheless, based on Asdarchoid affinities, it was most probably a terrestrial carnivore or omnivore. The closely related Thalassodromeus was specialized for larger prey, while both Tupuxuara species lack such specializations. A subadult described by David Marl and Darren Naish from the University of Portsmouth in 2006 had not yet fully developed its crest, supporting the suggestion that the crest was a marker for sexual maturity. Comparisons between the scleral rings of Tupuxuara and modern birds and reptiles suggests that it was possibly diurnal, active during the day and resting at night. Species include the type species Tupuxuara longicristatus, and other species like Tupuxuara leonardii and Tupuxuara leiridamus. The specific name longicristatus means long-crested in Latin. It was a terrestrial carnivore or omnivore, though some suggest piscivorous or frugivorous specialization. It had a wingspan of 18 feet or 5.5 meters. It has been discovered in the Santana Formation in Brazil. It lived during the Albian of the Cretaceous 112.6 to 109 million years ago, and fossil representation includes several specimens, together revealing the complete morphology. And with that, thank you for watching! Sarcosuchus video out soon, and possibly the next video may be about why did animals begin to live on land. I'm planning to learn 3D modeling and Adobe Illustrator to provide more high quality graphics and media for use in my videos. I'm still very excited about what's to come in this channel, and I'm slowly paving the way for branching out to other topics, even of folklore, theology, and religion, with a video on Artsgang, a Swedish folk tradition which I experienced in the video game Yearwalk, one of my favorite video games, and one that I definitely recommend. I might also make a video on the making of Fallout 4, simply because the game is legendary. I haven't forgotten about the other ideas, but I'm also coming up with new ideas and trying different things. We are halfway through the race to 1,000 subscribers, so that's great. As always, this is Enchiridion, see you next time.